No, my country people, it don't end, pata pata. It don't finish. This matter don't finish. 30 minutes ago, they see Wumi Mohbad wife for street. They pick paper. No, my country people, not be smart, you know. If I be Wumi, I for don't go confess since. Because the way this issue they go now, eh, anybody will not say get hand for waiting by Imole. Now so angry they touch them one after the other. Now so angry they touch them one by one, one by one. One policeman don't go down. No. But my people, not be smart, you know, for this mobile issue. Mobile spirit is strong. It's strong, die. Make I just drop the audio with you guys so that when I go use my ear, hear what they happen. Stay tuned.
As they start, they don't know. The next thing we will see, they will say, don't they pick the thing for road. They pick the thing. The thing will enter. Are you? You say, DNA, you know what to make, go bring this thing. Nah, they say you know what to do again. See, people don't that say, guy, now, that, you know me. God will bless him.
Yes, sir.
That answer. God will bless him. The rest of the sedan there.
They keep quiet.
They carry people begin. No, it not be their own. You say, best of the 10 feather flows together now. That's what they carry. If they see they will carry, then I make all of them keep quiet. That make them keep quiet now. I say, we'll give you picking where you don't get. You go country now. Reach your university level. And now, even the motor. See, where you show them. Where they're not that road, picking with that Adura.
Adura, baby.
That's how she can be.
I saw a bill. So how don't they touch them? They're not they sleep well. How don't they touch them?
See the small children, and now see the small children where she go. Eh?
The senior one died for inside. The senior one died for inside.
No.
Oh boy, so many things they happen on.
Good evening. Do you want me to talk?
Yeah, go ahead. You see the confidence with Daddy Mobate they talk.
I'm watching the game. I'm actually watching the game because Wumi, you see, it's a shame. Honestly speaking, it's a shame to our values. It's a shame to our traditional culture. I feel bad each time I see this because if you Google on the internet, Nigeria has is the second largest of paternity fraud.
Okay, now.
is the second largest of paternity fraud. And that's why you see, there's a country, it's still a black country. I don't want to mention it so that I don't stereotype the country. But like, Nigeria is the second fraudulent paternity fraud. So that shows the height of the promiscuity among our women. That is what it shows. And you can see, I've always told you that Wumi is a Delilah. She was a fine. Her mission is what she just completed now. Their mission has been completed. Because there's no way, you know, any woman that's very controlling and manipulative is from the pit of hell. Any woman you see that want to control the husband, control everything, that's not a woman. That's a wolf. That's not a woman. I keep saying that. You know, it's just a shame that this girl is denting, it's a national something, and she's busy denting Nigerians. But I'm happy I'm not from Yoruba. I'm really happy because it's the same thing. You know, so they will now identify what they are doing, the way they are disgracing themselves online about paternity fraud. You know, at least the whole world is
this one.
Them.
This one, this paternity fraud thing is a national issue. It's everywhere.
Yeah, it's a national issue.
It's everywhere.
Google it. Nigeria is the second largest. You know, it's not the first time it's happening. It's been happening before. A lot of this scenario has happened. It's just that Mohbad is a star and God is ready to disgrace them. A lot of women do that. And so many families, how many families ask for DNA? They don't. They just make baby and you think it's a baby. No, a lot of men should be vigilant now. At least this is an eye-opener to everybody. You know, my father says that when you live a careless life, you buy carelessly. That is what it is. You know, I sometimes, you know, all this whole red flag showed. They saw it. The father saw it. The sister saw it. Everybody saw these things and nobody was able to save this guy. You know, they were all carried away. Nobody. Everybody was carried. Even his friends that were supposed to save him. This guy discarded them. Any of his friends that knows what she knows, she will discharge them. A manipulative soul.
Very manipulative.
You see, and this is her game. She's gotten what she wanted. She sat on the wealth. She's fighting the father. She's fighting everybody. Yeah, well, let's see. Even the law, if Nigeria, I don't even trust Nigerian judiciary because it's a shame. From the beginning, Nigerian judiciary is a shame. We don't have a judiciary. We don't. You know, there's something like judiciary in Nigeria. It's a big shamble. You know, because if really we have judiciary, what is the need for this bloody corona inquest? That is a waste of time. Corona inquest is a waste of time. If we have judiciary that works, if we have police that works, how can this kind of homicide case be on the internet, messing about on the internet? We are not seeing the head, we are not seeing the tail. The police are comfortable. The judiciary is comfortable, like nothing. This stupid governor, someone is there, not doing anything. He's just messing about, speaking wrong English. They were asking him the other day, how can they salvage the famine in Nigeria that people are suffering? He's talking about food bank. People can cook. He cannot even invent good things. You know, just good things to just salvage the poverty estate. He cannot do nothing. He's talking about food bank. In Nigeria, we pay mama puts. They'll be cooking and people are coming to eat it. Stupid man, brainless man. You know, I feel so sad. He used to be a fraudster in the U.S. That's someone you are seeing. He's a fraudster. You know, he's an ex-convict. You know, so that all these people around, those are the people that is messing up the government. People that have brain, they won't give them opportunity to work with the country. They're giving tax, agbelos, people that are from nowhere, a position. That's why nothing is working. Look at the police station. How can you, prime boy, he came to sign according to your law. You detain him. You put a handcuff in his leg and his hand. Is he running away? Why are you putting handcuff? Why can you see the useless police people what they're doing? You know, it's so sad to see what is going on. I don't know what's going to happen because I don't have faith in that judiciary, to be honest. I have to be honest. I don't have faith in it. No matter how the English they speak, I do not have faith. Because in judiciary of Nigeria, I do not. Ghana, the Ghana judicial system is better than Nigeria judicial system.
Yeah, a lot better.
You know, a lot better. You know, because if this thing had happened in Ghana, by now it's a closed case. You know, Ghana is better 10 times. Their judicial system, their police system, everything is better. Nigeria is bloody corrupt in everything. Absolutely corrupt, you know. So, and it's sickly to see young boys, young girls, you know, the same system is going. In fact, that country needs a total overhauling. Everything has to change if they want that country to run again and live like a normal country. Nothing is working there, believe you me. Thank you, my sister.
God bless you. Thank you. Oh, wow, nothing is working in our country. Sister.